Master Kota is dead?
Yes.
His lightsaber. My spies have located another Jedi. Kazdan Paratus is far more powerful than you. I do not expect you to survive. But if you destroy him, you'll be one step closer to your destiny.
The Emperor?
Yes. Only together can we defeat him.
I will not fail you, my master.
Amazing. It looks just like the Jedi Temple on Coruscant.
Proxy, are you picking up any communications?
Too many to decipher. I can hear thousands of droids all calling out to each other. This is where all droids go to die.
Set us down as close to that thing as you can.
I'll do my best, but there are not many clearings. You'll need to approach the temple on foot.
I'm returning to low orbit. Scanners show you'll need to make it through that large hyperdrive core in front of you. Once on the other side, you should be able to reach the junk temple. Good luck.
What's happening? This is Lightning Bolt Forever back again with more Star Wars The Force Unleashed Ultimate Sith Edition. When we last left off, we defeated Jedi Master Rom Kota above Nar Shaddaa, and now we've been given a new assignment by Darth Vader here, and it is to eliminate Master Kazdan Paratus here on the junk planet of Raxus Prime. So if we take a look at our objectives immediately here, our bonus objectives are to destroy 10 scavenger skiffs, get 250,000 force points, and get 15 holocrons. And you bet we'll be doing all that stuff here. So, yes, we have a, we just had a little zoom into that little generator down there, and that gives us a hint as to what we're supposed to do here. Also, if you read the, little tooltip down there, we have a new force power, which is Force Lightning, yeah.
You're going to need to find a way to get through that hyperdrive core. Is there anything nearby you could use as a makeshift explosive?
Yes, as a matter of fact, there is. If we use Force Lightning on the generators here, we can blow a hole in the hyperdrive core. That way we can pass through it. So, let's go ahead and jump down here. Yes, and yeah, the game's telling us to dash, but we more than well know about the Force Dash here. And I love that the Force Dash does not cost any Force points to use. Because if I remember in the Wii version, I believe it does. But anyway, we got our first holocron right across the way there.
I'm picking up scraps of Rodi's communication. You're approaching some sort of salvage operation.
I'll deal with them.
Nice. So, there's one of those there scavenger skiffs, and to destroy it, what the hell was that? We just used Force Lightning. Oh, man. I am getting my ass handed to me here. Come on. Come on, fellas. Yeah, we got Rodians. We got Rodians throwing junk and garbage at us and all that crazy stuff. Oh! Get back up here. And want... Oh, did it go? Yes, there we go. I wanted to destroy that second skiff. But anyway, yes. We have Force Lightning as a power, as a force power now, which unlocks a whole bunch of new abilities that we will be able to use later on. Like force combos and different, different powers all around, and yeah, we'll be able to see a lot of cool stuff. But anyway, yes, we need to navigate, this river of, toxic sludge here. And, we do that by, yes, using these platforms here to get across, and yes, we can use the dash ability. Yes, the game is telling us now we can infuse our lightsaber strike with Force Lightning by pressing, the mouse button and then Q, which is basically just done by attacking. Whoa! Let's grab this Sith holocron. We get some invincibility here. But yeah, that's really cool that we can get an invincibility with this thing here. Anywho, I can't remember what I was saying before that. Yeah, we can just use the Force Dash to navigate the toxic sludge and just push these Rodians into the into the acid there. Hey. Ooh, nice. The force camera there. And we have one last little generator here, which should blow a hole in the hyperdrive core so that we can enter it. So let's go ahead and head on across here. Wow! Just like that. Now, the scavenger skiff bonus objective there. Yeah, like we said, we need to destroy 10 of them. And hopefully, yes, there's another one right here. Yeah, a lot of them you'll be able to destroy in this area. Yeah, we can get at least 5 in this area. So yeah, half the objective complete. But yes, we'll also be we'll also see more skiffs later on. So if you don't get them, if you don't get a good number here, then not to worry, we will have plenty later.
Eclipse to Starkiller. We're picking up a lot of movement beyond that hyperdrive core.
A lot of movement behind, but also a lot of movement inside. We have Jawas, and yes, for some reason they're enemies. I don't know why. Little baby Jawas are not going to pose a threat to us. They can go down in one swipe of the lightsaber there. But where we want to go is yes, that's what happens if you attack and then use your lightning ability. Yes, your saber will be infused with force lightning, and okay, enough. Yeah, there we go. Get out of here, you little punk. Anyway, you little punk. Let's see. Now there is a holocron actually inside the core here, and it is up above. Let's see. Let's dash on over here. Let's use lightning on this guy. Yeah, our lightning attack is very weak, so we can't really do a whole lot with it right now. And there's the holocron. Yeah, through here's the way out. But to get to the holocron, whoa. Throwing bombs at us here. This will not stand here. Yeah, get out of here. So what we need to do is head over this way. Now what we need to do is find a way, or not head over that way. We need to go over this way. Head up this little ramp here. Go up here like this and like this. Now let's see. Yeah, basically you just need to find your way over there, and I think I just went in a... Yeah, I just went in a total circle. I know my way around this thing. Not to worry. Let's get up here. Now, let's IS. Jump, dash. There we go, and... Yeah, do the leaping slam there. Alright, we got a force power sphere. And then, yeah, just drop down. And, we can find our way out right here. Sweet, and whoop. Yeah, get out of here. Get out of here, fellas. Hurrah. Alright, so now we got rid of him. Let's wait for the force power to charge up a little bit here. Push on through, drop down. We got some Jawas here. It's not gonna pose a threat to us very much. Oh. Not going to pose a threat to us very much, and ooh, check it out, it's an old Republic gunship crashed right here. That's pretty neat stuff. But these guys here, something blew up over there. Oh man, just trying to throw. Just trying to throw an explosive canister over that way, but I don't think it worked. Because clearly it just blew up right in my face, whoa. Yeah, and this level starts off pretty easy, but it is, how did that guy survive? Yeah, you die. Yeah, this level starts off pretty easy, but there's, yeah, it gets, pretty difficult. It gets pretty difficult later on, I'd say probably about the second half of the level, and you'll see when we get there. But anyway, yeah, right now we're just, lowering these scrap metal parts right here to, make sure that we can safely pass on this bridge without getting rained on by the molten, I'm guessing like the molten acid there, what, if that's even a thing, I don't even know, but anyway, let's head out here.
Juno, I'm not sure what I'm looking at here, are you picking up anything?
Just some panic transmissions. The scavengers didn't expect any droid resistance.
Droid resistance? What do you mean? Whoa, uh-oh, we got, oh yeah, here's the start of where this level kind of gets a little tough. So these junk droids here, They are... Let's blast that scavenger skiff there. These junk droids here, they are they're tough. They're not really that hard, but once you get the rhythm down and kind of know how to defeat them, they're not so bad. But the thing about them is that they're immune to force push. Oh, wow, nice jump there, fellas. They do not, you cannot force push them. It has no effect on them. See, they just get tossed back a little bit, and then they just get right back up into the fight. The easiest way to defeat them, as far as using the force goes, is with force lightning. And let's destroy, that's 9 skiffs down. Let's push that. There we go. I was trying to run away before that guy could attack me there. Oh, well. Trying to get away, like I was saying, before that guy could attack me there, but clearly that did not work. And I'll just throw these guys off the edge here. Alright, so. It looks like it's all the skiffs for this part here. So we'll, we'll be seeing some more skiffs later on. But, yeah. There we go. Yes, you die. There we go. Alright, another holocron in here. You can either just hack up the wall with your saber. We get the compressed red saber crystal. But yeah, to get it, you can either hack up the wall with your lightsaber or just force push the wall. Now we gotta lift this thing up because we need to get to the other side. Come on. There we go. We need to get to this end over here, and yeah, you just jump up and dash right there. You can blast open the entrance. What? How did I end up down here? Oh, this game. Oh, this game. It can be just hilarious sometimes, but there we go. At least I exploded his ass, but anyway. Now, let's go ahead and, drop down here.
How strange. The scanners aren't picking up any power signatures from those drawings. It's as if they're being powered by
the Force.
Yep. We should have known. Should have known that these are Force droids. Oh yeah, look at that saber flurry. That was just beautimous. Beautimous right there. Oh, nice. But yes. It's clear now that obviously Kazdan Paratus is powering these droids, and we don't know what this Kazdan Paratus character looks like here.
Eclipse to Starkiller. Watch your step. Readouts are showing a massive river of toxic hyperdrive plasma nearby.
I copy.
You'll need to find a way into the scavenger's camp nearby. Head through the bottom of that blockade room.
Nice. So yeah, holocron number 5 is right over here, and we can level up. Nice. And yes, as you saw, we also completed our bonus objective there. We destroyed 10 skiffs. And so why don't we go ahead and upgrade here? Just so we can see what we can work with here. So let's see, we got 4. Well, yeah, we'll put some into Force Lightning. Why not? All right. And if we go over to Force Talents, we got 3 here. What's Fortitude? Increases your maximum health. Yeah, we'll do that one. And then we will do Saber Mastery there. All right. And yeah, what does Saber Mastery do? Each rank increases the amount of damage you deal with your saber in melee combat. Oh yeah, that's an important one to have. And then we got the combos here. Now there's one combo I've been had my eye on when I was practicing this level. I don't think it was that one. I think lightning fuses. Yes, ends with an upward sweep. The Sith Slash is what I want here. And I don't see any other ones here. But yes, the Sith Slash, as you see, all you have to do is press attack and then the Force Lightning key twice. And yes, a lightning-infused lightsaber attack ends with an upward sweep. And that's a pretty sight to see right there. We're going to demonstrate it right here. Well, yep, just like that. All right. Oh. Nice. And since we... Whoa! Yeah, all right, yeah. Since we also upgraded Force Lightning, we can also deal more damage with it, as you'll see, and hit more targets at once. And whoa! Oh, the poor Jawas. Oh, that was a bomb. Yes, we can do a ton more damage just by upgrading it once here. Let's just send that send that guy flying right there. Let's see. Let's wind up another force push attack. Hoo-yah! Nice, 10,000 force points. So let's go up this way. Alright, yeah, this, I always thought that was kind of a weird part in this level, and I edited it out, but, there's a loading screen in the middle of this level that, this is a pretty big level, I mean, as with most of the levels in this game, but, if there were any weird cuts there, then, that'd be why. Just because I wanted to edit out the loading screens without, you having to sit through them. All right, and then this guy, he needs to go somewhere. So let's go ahead and head up this way, and whoa, send that guy flying. Make sure he doesn't get in our way. Oh, who threw that at me? You come here. No. Oh, what the heck, man? There. Somebody's throwing something at me, and I don't know where it's coming from. I don't know if it's the melee guys or the guys with the blaster or what. You! Come here! Get out of there. Alright. Let's open up this... Yeah, let's open up... Whoa! Pushing me all the way to the side. Let's open up these doors here. Alright. And we come to this open area here, and... Uh-oh! Yeah, make sure you've collected everything once you enter this area, because there's no going back. But anyway, yeah, we got up. Whoa. Hold it. Whoa, I just brought down the whole roof there. That was wild. All right, anyway. When you get into this area, yes, our main pathway is off to the right, as you saw in that little, cutscene there. But what we need to do... Well, first we need to get rid of all these Rodians. And yeah, we can pick up a damage increase holocron here. And, what we can do, there are two holocrons in this opening area, well, two Jedi holocrons. One of them is off to the left right here. We get the gold lightsaber crystal, very nice. And, one's off to the left on that, that walkway right there. Aw, little baby Jawa. He just can't stay in the same league as the big boys. Come on. Oh, yeah, there we go, that's what I, that's what I was hoping for. I was hoping I'd push him into the force field there. Whoa, damn, sent him flying. But yeah, one's off, oh yeah, get out of here. Love that attack. And there's one very similar to that that deals even more damage. Oh, you, no. Here, get out of here. But anyway, yeah, one holocron off to the left, one off to the right when you first come into this area, so. And, oh, you come here, you little weasel. Get out of here. Anyway, yes, let's go through. Yeah, as you can see, we need to deactivate that big old force field up there. So the way we do that is by running over here. And this will take us down. And we'll head around here. Now, when you get into this next open area here, head off to the right. Because, let's go ahead and get a holocron. We get the compressed yellow lightsaber crystal. And also, I like running over to the right because there's not as many enemies over here, and there is this guy. But, yeah, there's not as many enemies over here, and it gives you kind of a safe space to hide, and, you know, until you blow yourself up with explosives there. And where is that guy going? Yeah, get out of here. Alright, there's that guy. Now, there should be another holocron underneath here somewhere. Let's get that Jawa out of the way. Yes, we get a Force Talent Sphere. Hey! Freaking... Oh my... Get out of here. Yeah, you get the extra damaging lightning attack. Because you stink. I don't know. Get out of here. Alright. And anyway, yeah, you can like move these little generators around and throw them. But what you can also do, and because this level's so force lightning heavy and requires you to do so many things with it, you can... Hopefully I can like show it off here. Yeah, here's one. You can electrify them, and yeah, you can just destroy them like that, and if they're nearby enemies, you can use them as explosives to take out a whole bunch of guys. But anyway, let's move this generator onto the other side of the track here, like so. Ooh, damn. I know you think it's just going to turn the shield generator off, but now it blows that thing up. Anyway, let's go ahead and head back now, because we can actually go through there. Where are you guys going? Oh, nice dodge, but didn't really work there, did it? Yeah, I didn't think so. Yeah, you can get out of here. And Mr. Jawa here. Now, I don't think there's... What's over here? Yeah, there's just these objects that you can pick up and move around here, but nothing really all that special. And I don't think there's anything up here. Yeah, this is just the other side of that one area we were at before, so... Yeah, and... You know, I never noticed that until just now. That's a Jawa Sandcrawler right there. That's really cool. I never knew that was there before. Anywho... Let's get back up to the higher level here. Oh, yep, and we got a huge ambush waiting for us. Well, not huge, but it's a decent-sized ambush. Pretty big ambush, I would say. Waiting for us at the top of the elevator. No, Jawa, do not use your flamethrower on me. This guy. Push that guy, and we'll lift that guy up into the air. Whoa! I don't think so, buddy. Away with you.
No, yeah.
Yeah. One more Jawa for good measure. Oh, somebody still needs to... I heard gunfire. Where is that coming from, I wonder? I hear... He's firing at me from somewhere. I can't tell where, though. Oh, there you are. Oh, you were hiding this whole time. Very smart of you, but shouldn't have fired at the last second there. Could have left you alive, because I didn't know you were there, but... Alas, you know, things just couldn't turn out the way you wanted them to, now could they? No, I don't know. Anyway, let's go ahead and hop down here. And this is going to take us to... this area. Oh, and we got these guys. I hate these guys. They don't hurt you directly... But notice, they're zapping... Yeah, they zap your force energy. They'll just drain it from you. These scrap drones here. And, yeah. Don't do any damage, but they'll zap your force energy. And, it makes it very hard to, deal with other enemies that are around if you want to use force powers and all that stuff, so... Yes, so now we'll come down here. And we must find a way across this junk chasm here. Now, whoa, we got another one of these guys. Ah! Yeah, come here. Throw you down there. Yeah, you can, Ooh, that was pretty cool, huh. I wonder if we'll ever need that thing for something. I don't know. Anyway, when you get... Yes. Obvious foreshadowing is obvious. When you get into this area... you want to come to the left and, electrify the giant heater here. Because it's going to melt this, metal... thing. I don't really know what it is, but it's going to... Uh-oh. What? Oh, what the... Whoa, what is this thing? What is that? Oh. Uh-oh. We'll deal with that thing in a... Oh, man. We'll deal with that thing in a second. For right now, we got more immediate... Oh, no. Don't die. We got more immediate threats to worry about here. So, yes... Yeah, you can use that metal plank as a bridge there, is what we zapped the thing for. Now, this thing here, this is a junk titan. And basically, you can electrify it and paralyze it with the tower above its head. But basically, this thing has a bunch of attacks. It'll throw stuff at you, it'll light you on fire, it'll swing around with a bunch of melee attacks. The easiest way to defeat it... You can actually just do a big old force lightning spam here. And once you whittle it down to enough health here, just like the ATCT from the last level, because it's technically not an ATST, yes, you can perform a finishing combo at the very end and just blow it to smithereens there. And now, we have the ability to upgrade again, so let's grab, yes, more 10,000 force points, another force points, yeah, force points holocron there. And what we're going to do is... Well, let's see. Yeah, there we go. That's what I want to do, yeah. The lightning works very well against the droids, so... Yes. We'll come up here. We'll get the damage increased, even though we don't really need it. And before we progress, let's go ahead and upgrade here. Let's see. We can't really do much in the Force Power section. We have three more abilities that are still locked, and they don't become unlocked until the next level. But with this, I think what we'll do... Let's see, what's in Vitality? Each rank increases the amount of health you gain. Yes, we'll put those into Vitality there. And let's see, if we go to the combos... Aerial Strike. Is it that one? No. There's another lightning-based ability that I wanted to... Ah, yes, here it is, the Saber Smash. And yes, we have three, so we'll go ahead and put it in there. This will give us, basically any one of those control combinations will trigger this attack. And it's kind of the successor to the attack you were seeing earlier there. And basically for this, what we're going to do is just grip it, and that will allow us... Yes, that will allow us to make ourselves a bridge. Now, I don't trust myself jumping straight down onto this thing, so let's dash to the other side. Oh, and real quick, before we progress, because I meant to do this last time, yes, I want to check and see, yeah. Got all the, oh wait. Oh, okay. Yes, not very far with objectives there. We've got the right amount of holocrons, and we are not far from getting our Force combo points there. Whoop! And yeah, you can kind of see it there. Kind of a little... the game kind of glitched out there. It kind of showed the droid before he even appeared. But anyway, this new attack that we've got going on here, it's a beast of an attack here. Yep, and that's how it works. You just electrify the whole place here. Any enemy in range of that lightsaber is instantly just, like, totally wrecked. Oh, yeah. It's great. Anyway, let's lower down this metal scrap here. Make ourselves a platform to jump on, and, yeah, leave it just like that. Now, I don't think... Yeah, there's a little platform over there, as you can see, but there's no reason to really go over there. Whoa. Okay, everybody just... Go, Starkiller, go. There we go. Woo! Okay, so the beaten path is down that way, but we're going to take a slight detour. We're going to go this way into this little optional area here. Well, I say optional in the sense that you don't need to go this way to progress through the level. But you do need to go this way if you're trying to get 100%. So what we can do is lower down. Whoa, these platforms here. And yeah, getting onto the holocron platform is easy, and we get a new costume for Starkiller, the Sith robe. Now, I'm hoping... You know what? I don't trust myself, so what I'm going to do... Because I'm recording. I know it's going to happen because I'm recording. What I'm going to do is actually go back this way. I'm actually going to bring down this platform here, jump over onto it, and then... get onto this platform. Because, yeah, like, when I was practicing this level, I would just jump from the far one over to this near one here. But, you know how it goes with... Whoop. That's what I meant to do. You know how it goes with, trying to... Oh, no. No. You know how it goes with trying to record and, you know, not die. But, you know, chances are something always goes wrong with recording. And these droids here, they need to get out of here so we can get our... Force energy back. Yeah, just like that. Yeah, get out of here. Oh, yeah. And, obviously, as you can already tell, Force Lightning is the Force power we're pretty much going to be using primarily throughout the game here, so. Yeah, get used to seeing a lot of, electrocution. But anyway, let's go ahead and fall down here. Now, we got another Junk Titan, and we don't have an electrical tower to stall him here, so yeah, I'd just like to do a nice little, Force Lightning spam here. Do a nice little combo, and, I try not to take too much time throwing items at this guy, because, or really just any of the junk titans in general, because while you're doing that, it, I don't know, for whatever reason, it seems like they have more than enough time to... Oh yeah, that was so cool. That was such a cool finishing move. But yeah, it always seems like they have way more, what you call it, time to, like, hit you with something, too. Anyway, yeah, force point holocron right there. Well, I was trying to just, yeah, there we go. Yeah. I was trying to use the AT-ST head to, get to the top here. Yes, we have number 14 holocron is the Furcon power crystal for the saber, and the last holocron gives us 10,000 force points and a force power sphere. So, we look at our objectives. We have all secondary objectives complete. All that's left to do now is take out Kazdan Paratus, who is in the next room, as a matter of fact. And with that, we will just... I don't think we can really do anything over here with the force combos, so yeah, we will leave the force power screen, and now we'll head over to the lightsaber screen. And if we head over to the power crystal section, yes, we were using the Rubot crystal in the last level, but yes, this one, the Furcon crystal, lightsaber attacks have a chance to deal extra electrical damage, and that is the one we will be using for our fight with Kazdan Paratus. So let's head on up, and let's take him down.
Kazdan Paratus at last.
Don't worry, masters. I'll defend you from this Sith trash.
Sith trash? Oh, this guy, he's insane. Oh, yeah. But anyway, we've got the battle with Kazdan Paratus here, and this fight, I gotta say, for only the second big fight in the game, this is actually a pretty difficult battle. It's like, I think it's a lot more difficult than the other... I think it's a lot more difficult than some of the fights, like, even later on in the game, because he does a lot of damage. But, Starkiller block, there we go. Yeah, he does, a lot of damage, but a couple of effective, a couple of effective attacks. Yeah, see, if you get wedged into a corner, you're pretty much screwed, because, yeah. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, a couple of effective attacks include Force Lightning, the jump, and, a couple of attacks include Force Lightning, the downward smash after jumping in the air, and, yes, a lot of the lightning combos. Yeah, because if there's one thing this level hammers in... Oh yeah, it's Force Lightning combat. Oh, and here we are tied in a Force Lock here. Press Q when the needle is in the red zone. So, and... Yeah, you probably only have to do it like 3 or 4 times here.
I will defend the Jedi Council!
Oh man. Let's see, where'd he go? Yeah. At some point when you whittle him down to a certain amount of health, what he'll do... Yes, he will, he'll blow a hole open in the wall. It'll basically just, you know, open up the entire room. And I can't see where I am. There we go. He'll just open up the entire room and conjure up one of these junk titans here. And, yeah, basically it's just the same fight as, the other two that we saw in the main level. Only this time, since we're using the lightning crystal with our saber, it's a little bit easier to do damage to him. And the good thing is... Yes, he doesn't take that many hits anyway. But the good thing is, once we knock him down, we will get a ton of health back so that we are not completely weakened when we're dealing with Kazdan Paratus here. Yeah, because after he... Gosh, man. Whoa. Yeah, he'll go chasing you around with a bunch of objects there. Yeah, you can even do damage to him while he's hopping on the
Masters,
wall there.
Give me the strength to kill this Sith!
To kill this Sith! Yeah, he's insane. This man, I don't even know what he is. See, he's just like, he's really good at getting out of... He's really good at getting out of the combo moves there. I need some more health. I don't think I even did any damage to him there. Oh, block.
I will stop him, Master Yoda. I will.
Oof. See, he does those freaking force push attacks on you, and it's like, oh, there we go.
You are not.
Come on, Kazdan, I need you to climb back up there. Get another junk titan out here. There he goes. Yep, he's he'll do his force repulse, and yep, there he goes, climbing up the wall again. But yeah, he's a freaky little monster, isn't he? Yeah. Cool thing about the junk titans, at least in this area, is that you can do damage to them while they're spawning in, which is actually like pretty. I don't know. I feel like that shouldn't happen, but it's a very useful thing. Because you could basically kill it like only seconds after it spawns in. Get a bunch of health back here. Now. Yeah, what you can also do is the objects that
you have no right to the force.
Yeah, he'll basically make sure you get out of the way when he does that leaping attack there. Whoa, send him flying. But yeah, you can even throw objects back at him. I don't think it'll do, or not throw objects at him, but you can throw objects out of the way so that they can't hit you. Yeah, just whittle him down to his last little bit of health here. Yeah. I feel like he has like kind of a grace period where he's just like invulnerable to all damage, but whoa, come on now, there we go. That saber lock. Now. Here we go. Finally doing the finishing combo on him here. Yeah, alright. Sweet.
I'm sorry, Masters. I've failed you again.
Juno, I'm done here.
Alright, so we have finished our mission on Raxus Prime, and we've completed all objectives, like the previous mission, and, we got a whole bunch of rewards for completing this mission as well. So, when we come back, I will see you on Felucia, the next planet we will be heading off to. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.